Hi everyone, so in this video let's look at the statistics questions in 2020 NTA NET Commerce Shift 1 question paper. So a total of 7 questions were asked from this section, which were mostly direct. So questions were asked from the sections of central tendency. Actually there were 2 questions from the area of measures of central tendency. Further questions were asked from binomial distribution, standard error, regression coefficients, report writing, that's basically the primary data collection area, and probability. So let's look into the questions one by one, because they were relatively easy. We'll explain each of the questions. For the first question, which of the following are positional averages? Arithmetic mean, median, mode, geometric mean, and harmonic mean. Choose the most appropriate answer. B and C only, BCD only, BCA only, A, B, C, D only. So when you look at what is positional average, what is mathematical average? So basically when an average is determined on the basis of the position, it is called positional average. So basically it's median or mode. Why? Because median, how do you find a median? In a series, you arrange the series in ascending order or descending order and you take the middle value. If it is an even number of series, you take the average of the middle value. That is basically median. And the most repeating value in a series forms the mode. So basically these two measures depend on where they are positioned. So the average that is determined on the basis of position is called positional average. So in the answer it will be median and mode. So B and C only. So it is option 1. But let's also look at what is mathematical average. Average obtained after mathematical test are called mathematical averages. For example, arithmetic mean, geometric mean, harmonic mean, etc. So for this question the answer is positional average. We are looking at median and mode, so answer 1. Next question, the standard deviation of the binomial distribution is NP, root of NP, NPQ, root of NPQ. So by formula we know that the mean of a standard distribution, mean of a binomial distribution is NP, and standard deviation of a binomial distribution is NPQ, where N is the number of items, P is the probability of event 1, and Q is 1 minus P. So a total number of probability, total value of the probability is always equal to 1, and we know that P plus Q is equal to 1, which is P, Q and N we have. N is the number of items in the sample. So the mean of a binomial distribution is NP and standard deviation of a binomial distribution is NPQ. So from the option it is 3. Now moving on, question 48. When sampling is done without replacement, what is the standard error of mean? So when sampling is done without replacement, what we need to see is, in the case of sampling without replacement, the basic idea is all the remaining units will have equal chance to get selected each time. As in the sample, say there are 5 balls. You take one ball and now you are not putting that ball back. Now the remaining 4 balls have an equal chance of getting selected. You take one more ball. Now you are not putting this ball back either. So you have the remaining 3 balls have an equal chance of getting selected the next time. Likewise, you keep on taking and you calculate on the basis of the remaining number of balls. So you don't replace the balls. In such a case, all the remaining units will have equal chance to get selected each time. To find the standard error, we add a finite population correction, n minus 1. So where capital N is the population size and small n is the sample size. So the formula is basically option 2, where we have the correction factor. So standard error of x is equal to sigma by root n root of capital N minus n divided by capital N minus 1, which is the sample finite population correction. So this is the formula for standard error of mean. Now the next question, which of the following is true in a model distribution? Mean minus mode equal to 3 into mean minus median, mode is equal to 3 into median minus 2 mean, 3 median is equal to 2 mean plus mode, and 2 median minus 3 quartile deviation is equal to 2 mean. So we know that the relationship between mean, median and mode is nothing but mean minus mode is equal to 3 into mean minus median. So option 1 is the answer. Now question 75, the regression coefficient is independent of the change of scale only, origin only, both scale and origin, neither scale nor origin. Now we need to be careful while answering this question, because the options are again given as A only, B only, C only and D only. So we need to see what is it actually. So basically the regression coefficient is independent of only origin and not scale, that is by property of a regression coefficient. So we need to see the explanation. There will be no effect on the regression coefficient if any constant is added or subtracted to the coefficients, but if anything is multiplied, if the scale is changed, it will change the regression coefficient. So regression coefficient is independent of origin but not of scale. So the answer is 2. Arrange the following stages of research in a proper sequence. We have report writing, budgeting, data collection, field work and research outcome. So basically by economic sense, when we look at it, before doing a study we need to keep a budget. So option B is the first one. After taking the budget of how far you can carry out the study, how much stretch can you conduct the study, you decide that you go to the field and then you collect the data, you get the outcome, you write the report. That's the basic essence of it. You budget your study, you do the field work, you collect your data, you get your research outcome and you write the report. So it's basically B and then D, BDC, BDCE and BDCEA. So what is the option? B, starting with B, we have only 2. We need, anyways, budgeting is the predominant thing to do. So B, and then you do what? After budgeting, you go to the field. So the second option is given as E. No, after budgeting you don't directly get the research outcome. You have to go to the field and collect the data, get the research outcome and then you write your report. So this is the only sensible research process in this option. So B, D, C, E, A. Option 1 is the answer. Coming to the last question, match the following list 1 with list 2. We have Bayes' theorem, conditional probability, theorem of complementary events and theorem of addition and their respective formulas. This is a direct question from probability, we just need to know the formulas. So looking at this itself, we can see that it's option 3 actually. So Bayes' theorem is nothing but P of E2 by E1, E1 given E2 divided by P of E1. That is the formula for Bayes' theorem. Conditional probability is nothing but P of H1 by E is equal to P of H1 given E divided by P of E. Again, C, theorem of complementary events, P of E bar is equal to 1 minus P of E. So complementary event is nothing but the sum of a complementary event and its event will be equal to 1. Theorem of addition, we have 2, P of E1 union U2. So addition is given by union, E1 union E2 is given by P of E1 plus P of E2. So the total additional probability value will be the summation of the individual probability values. So these are just direct theorems. So most of the questions were direct and easy to answer. So hope you all understood the video. So this was the 2020 NTA Commerce Shift 1 questions. So we will soon come back with Shift 2 questions. Thank you.